Thousands of Kiwi kids had access to free counselling sessions thanks to Mike King's Gumboot Friday fundraiser last year. So ahead of this year's appeal, he's changing things up by jumping on a tractor and heading around the country. Why, you ask? Well, he is here to tell us himself.
Good morning. Yeah, it's lovely to be here.
And so lovely to have you in.
Oh, congratulations, by the way.
Oh, thank you.
So beautiful.
Thanks. And congratulations to you on such a good space right now.
Nothing like a near-death experience to remind you what's important in life. And for me, what's important right now is caring for our kids, you know. Yeah. So last year we raised $1.3 million for free kids counselling, and we're kind of blown away by how many kids took it up.
Yeah.
There was 10,670 sessions we were able to fund, but the ages of the kids that were taking it up, the kids that took it up the most were 8 to 11-year-olds.
It's so sad, isn't it?
No, it's not. You see, this is what we got to change. This is what I love about this conversation. I was with the Minister of Health and he said, oh, I didn't realise it was such a big problem. And the reason we think like this is because in this country we fund crisis. So automatically when you mention counsellor now, your first thought is crisis.
No.
But here's how we've got to think about it. Like, I don't go to the doctor and get my prostate checked because I'm unwell. I go to stay well.
Right.
My wife doesn't go to the gym to get fit. She goes to stay fit. Our kids are going to counsellors not because they're mentally unwell. Mm. They go to counselling to stay well. It's a proactive and positive way. This is the biggest muscle in the human body, and our kids recognise that it needs exercising.
The thing is, because it's so invisible,
mm-hmm.
If you look at counselling, and you came across this, it's expensive.
But which is why we do it for free. But here's the beautiful thing. Our system is a voluntary system. And here's what we discovered. So we let the counsellors charge whatever they charge. Some charge $400, some charge free. What it averaged out at was $121 per session, which is the same as the government subsidy. And even more importantly, the government gives 6 sessions and it's never enough. We said, have as many as you want. Guess what? 4.5 was the average. And the most important one for me is under the government scheme, it's about 80-20, 80 girls, 20 boys. Under our scheme, it was 55-45.
Why do you think that is?
Because if you empower boys to recognise that their mental health is important and give them the choice to go and do it, they will.
Yeah.
But if you tell anyone that you need to go, and if you do go, you're mentally ill, they don't go. See, here's the thing. In New Zealand, the only way a child can access free counselling is if someone diagnoses them mentally ill.
Yeah.
Kids don't want to go because they're mentally ill. They want to go to stay well.
Yeah.
And we have to change this. And it's not the kids.
It's like going to the gym.
Yep. And it's our generation that has to change. Remember your reaction when I said 8 to 11? You went, oh, my. Yes, so straight away, that stigma.
Yeah.
Straight away, that's stigmatising. So, you know, we used to go, when people go to the gym, oh, you're fat. That's what we used to say, right? Oh, I didn't know. You look fine. But now it's about, you know, it's about taking care of ourselves. And that's what I love about this generation of kids. And I want to do everything in my power to get them the counselling that they need for free.
You mentioned that boys in particular mm-hmm. need to be empowered.
Yeah.
Do you find that in rural communities it's even harder?
Well, what we found last year was rural communities, and we saw this in who was taking up the counselling, in rural communities it was seen as a city problem.
Right.
You know, and you know, they're rugged farmer types who have rugged parents. So this time what we're doing is we want to take it to rural communities and just let them know that counselling is for everyone, and we're also taking a counsellor on the road with us. One of the counsellors who had the most kids who during the Gumboot, out of the Gumboot Friday fund, and have her explain. And she's just an ordinary New Zealand girl mm-hmm. who's an amazing counsellor, and show the kids' parents the benefit. The kids will take it up.
Yeah.
All kids will take it up. But it all starts at home.
Yeah.
You've got to be given permission from home. So we're in that whole changing attitude space. We're into proactive care rather than reactive, which is what the government's funding.
And so you're going to be quite visible Yeah. You're going to be riding tractors. Yeah. Down the streets.
16 of them, plus the big black dog truck, a huge Big Mac truck. We've got, yeah, a trailer units. We've got lots of giveaways. We've got lots of fun. Can I just say one thing?
Yes.
Last year, there was a particularly nasty article that went out and said, Mike King runs out of money and councillors not paid. That was such a malicious and untrue headline. The Gumboot Friday Fund, all the money was allocated, $1.3 million. Where did it go? 100% of it went to councillors. Mm. When that money ran out, they made it... The subtext of the story was, I went broke and I can't be trusted
with
money.
Which is ridiculous.
It is horrible.
Isn't that... Shouldn't it show you how many people wanted to
That's right.
To
it should look. But I don't know. There's a thing in journalism now where we've got to tear people down. The second thing was, councillors left unpaid. Not one councillor who had approved funding was left unpaid. Every single councillor who was approved got paid. See, how it worked was, a councillor ring up, I've got a child. We'd allocate five sessions and then put that money to one side for that councillor. If they didn't use all the sessions, the money went back in. Because we have to check their bona fides, we have to check that they're actually registered councillors. We've got to check. So every single councillor who had approved funding got paid. So, look, we've got to stop tearing people down. Israel Alessandria said it the other day. You know, we're tearing people down. This isn't about me. This isn't about us. This is about our kids. And this is an opportunity where we can all get in there and do something good for our kids. One coffee on April the 3rd, Gumboot Friday. If you put that to free kids counselling, you're going to save lives. I just think it's such a cool thing.
That is beautiful. We're going to come out and see you on the road.
Yes.
Where can we? What stuff?
You want to drive a tractor? You need to drive a tractor.
I do.
You need to drive. How about you drive a tractor over the Harbour Bridge?
Oh, my God, I would love that.
Okay, done. Done deal.
Boss, you heard it here first.
So we'd need to do that live on the show, wouldn't
yes,
we?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. We'll get you across Harbour Bridge.
Awesome. Yeah, cool.
It'll be pregnant lady and runaway tractor.
blocking all traffic.
It's going to be cool.
Awesome. Cool. Thank you so much for coming in. Mike
Love
King.
You guys.
How's beautiful. Your shoulder?
It's great. It's really great. You know, the surgeons at Waikato Hospital, thank you for putting me back together. I feel like Steve Austin, $6 million man.